Hi guys, today we make a video about a canoe made by Game Park Holding. And after 2 weeks of use, I can tell you it's a pretty nice system. I mean, really nice design. Analog joystick is really nice, all button. Looks like it should be, and it worked properly. To be honest, when I got that system for the first day, I recognized that the shoulder button is a little bit too stiff. I did my own modification. I mean, if you see my previous video, which I was gonna remove it, I'll show you how I did that modification. That's a picture, actually, after when I done. That's the center of housing, and pretty much that, and that's where it shoulder button fit. And on that picture, you can see pretty much that piece, that plastic piece, it was molded on that center molding. Basically what I did with razor knife, I cut it, that piece out, and I put it inside that shoulder button and glue it together. I mean, glue it on. To be honest, you don't have to do that. When you cut it from that plastic, I mean, from the center piece, you cut it that little like plastic spring, and you throw it away. You don't have to glue it back on the trigger like I did, to be honest. Well, I did that, then next time when I opened it, I recognized it. When the plastic was molded, well, was still molded on the housing, it was working like a spring load, I mean like a spring. When you cut it out and glue it on back inside the shoulder button, it's not doing anything. Why? Because it's really, because it's cut off from that area. Before it was working like a spring, right now it doesn't do anything. And when you push the shoulder button, actually plastic piece, it actually pushes a switch, not this one. Pretty much with that modification, the button works much better in software. I mean, much better, like it should be, you feel it. And all around, actually, it's a pretty nice system. But there's still have a couple design flaw. First of all, the issue with screen. And what happened, pretty much, right now it's running a Sega Genesis emulator, Street of Rage, and you can see, I mean, right now it's running a full screen, and you, if you look it closer, you can see where it said time, I mean, well, you see numbers, and there's on top, it said time. You not can see right now from that position, but if you tilt the screen, well, I'm not sure if camera can pick it up, you can see it's under the bezels, it's still you can see it said time, and there's a green border from that little area, I mean little message window. Pretty much, actually, there's a few emulators, few programs which you will see that problem. And like on the Genesis emulator, there's settings which you can change it. Let me see that. And actually, it will work like it should be. Right now you can see. It's saying, I mean, you can see the time is running, and also the word itself is a time in the green light. Pretty much with screen issue, you're not really recognize it quite often. It has a problem. It looks like they put the screen a little bit bigger than a bezel open area, or bezel a little bit smaller than screen itself. But like I said, it's no big deal. The biggest design flaw that I saw, well, I mean, you can call one or another. I mean, I don't know who designed that. The speakers on the back, I mean, to be honest, it's really bad. I mean, they actually put quite loud, but I mean, when they put it on the back, it's not a really smart idea to do that. Why? Because when you hold in, sometimes you cover it in those holes, and the sound is not as good as it should be. Second of all, the volume control, I mean the sliding switch, to be honest, I mean, it's not as good as it should be. Plus, it's not really accurate. Right now it's always off, I mean always off. Then when you try to slide it, even as that's the lowest settings. I'm not sure if the camera can pick it up, but in some cases it still sounds a little bit too loud. You know, it will be nice if the switch will be more accurate and more sensitive and start from a much lower setting. Then the system has a non-start port, which I mean use it USB, and then that special game power connector, which I mean to be honest, it's really not. I mean, if you plug it like once a day or so, you know, just for charging, it's one thing. But when you transferring data back and forth, it's really annoying. It will be nice if it has a standard USB cable, and it should be will be nice. But to be honest, I mean, after a few weeks, I use that system. I can tell you, it's pretty good system actually. It has more good sides than bad. And I mean, my first impression actually, I was a little bit disappointed, especially with screen. I thought I will have to cut it bigger hole. I mean, to modify it to able to see a whole working area. Then I mean the button modification already done. I mean it's no big deal for me. The speakers I still working on bringing speakers up front instead on the back. But to be honest, I tried already a couple times. Well, I opened system more than a few times, and the original speakers there's no way can be in the front. It's a little bit too big. If they were like 2.5 millimeters smaller in diameter, they will fit. But like it is, they don't fit. I tried from PSP 1000. Still is too big. Especially the left. I'm sorry, full size SD. You see how close to, to front. There's not much room. I mean, over here it has a plenty room. It's like maybe 8-9 millimeters speaker with 2 millimeters thick. It will fit. Yeah, but I mean, find that speakers like that. I have to do something with a volume control, because that volume control is not really acceptable. Plus, like a slow motion. If you can hear it. But now it's gonna turn it on, and then I turn it back. You see, I push it all the way back. And the sound still continued running slowly to the end, probably like for a few seconds. I don't know why they designed like that. But anyway, like I said, it's a pretty good system. It has had a couple design flaws, but believe me, all systems they do have. MDS, PSP, you name it, they do have some design flaws. Well, I hope you enjoyed my video. Thank you so much, and bye-bye.